Hi guys and welcome back to the channel. Today I will show you how can you make your own studio LED for video production. Let's begin. First, let's have a look at some different type of LED to choose what type of LED will suit our need. I was thinking to go with some LED strips at the beginning, but after I remembered I was having some 1 watt LED laying around. But in the end, I choose to go with this 220 watts big LED cold and warm, because I will want to be able to adjust the color temperature on the fly. For cooling up the LED, I decided to go with these 2 Xbox 360 CPU coolers which I was having lying around. Maybe it sounds a bit overkill, but I like the LED to be passive cooled. And for powering up the LED individually, I choose these 2 step-up converters. They are based on the UC3843 with an output power up to 150 watts. Now let's start working on our heat sinks. First step will be to measure our LED dimension and drilling all the required holes for our LED and the lens. By the way, the lens I am using, they are 120 degrees for spreading out the light evenly. After we have the first cooler done, we need to move to the second one and repeat the same process. After all the holes they are done, we take some sandpaper, in my case I am using some 120 grit to smooth out the copper surface of the cooler. When we sand the surface, we're doing so in only one direction. Like that, we have a better heat transfer from the LED to our heat sinks. After the cooler they are ready, we will need to add some thermal paste. Don't use thermal pad, they are very inefficient for this kind of application. After, we can add our LED and the reflector. Now let's start assembling the LED to our heat sinks. First, we will need to place some thermal paste on a straight line, and after we can add the LED. After, we will add the LED reflector and the lens. And at the end, let's put our bracket and tidy it up using some M5 screws and bolts. Now we need to strap together the heatsinks using some small metal brackets. I brought these a while back, but it seems they are not the right size. We will need to cut them a bit from the edge because the bracket is interfering with our screws from the LED. After cutting with the Dremel, we will assemble the same way as with the LED. Now let's start working on the step-up converter. On them, we will need to replace the variable resistor, which they are 103, it means 10, and the third digit represents the number of 0 you must place after the 2 digit, in this case they are 10K variable resistance. And they will be replaced with this more easy to use variable resistor 10K potentiometers. After, we will test again to be sure it's working how it should. After, we can start wiring everything up. For the wiring, I am using this old AC cord which I was having from an old appliance. But before doing so, we'll need to make a small piece which will stay between the LED for our switch and the 2 variable resistor. We can make the board from an old sheet of metal, but in my case I will use this old sheet of wood which I was having lying around. Let's measuring and cutting, after let's drill the 3 holes, after we can start to do the wiring. After finishing the wiring, let's test it. As you can see, they work perfectly. Now I know my step-up converter, they don't have a current limiting function, but because the maximum voltage at the output is around 33 volts, our LED they will be just fine because they have a nominal working voltage around 21 to 38 volts, so the LED they will work pretty well. Now, after we have the module done, I would like to make a simple stand for it. And yes, I know the support supposed to be already in the video, but because due to the lack of the time I was having for making the support, I was using this old support from this old lamp. Let's remove the old two screws holding the funnel into place along the old bulb. After, we will need to remove the metal strip from the funnel of the lamp and drilling two holes in the middle of the strips to be able to mount it back on the arm. After, I insert the metal strip between the two heat sinks and I use some hot glue in combination with some zip ties to mount it firmly on the structure. After, the last thing to do is to solder the power jack. Let's measure with the multimeter to see which pin it's which, and after we will use some heat shrink tubings to isolate the connection. After, by flicking the switch on the front and by turning the two variable resistor, we can mix the temperature of the light from cold to warm. Now it seems I cannot power them at full power because the power supply I'm using is rated only to 1.5 amperes. But for the time being, they are just fine. And here it is, studio LED for video production. Okay guys, we get to the end of the video. This was all I was having for you today. I hope I will see you all in my next video. Until then, have a nice day and thank you very much for watching.
See ya.